Okay, now we have unit 9, part 2b, اللي هو, now this is practice number 3. Look at the map in number 2, complete the conversation. Starting with number 1. Hi, is there a bookshop near here? Yeah, let's put, okay, where is the bookshop? Here it is. So this is the bookshop. And let's write number 1, okay, over it. So this is the first place we are going to ask about. Now we have the directions, let's complete them. Yes, there's one on King's Road. So this is King's Road and this is the bookshop. Go
down.
Down, yeah, thank you. Go down. So this is the first, هلا بنسميها giving directions. I'm not اتجاهات. Go down this road. Okay. Now, remember, we are standing here at the bus stop, right? يعني بنرجع مرة تانية إنه we are standing here. That's why we are giving directions. Now, go down this road. لوين?
Turn right.
Turn right.
Okay. Turn right. So here we are going toward the word right at the coffee shop. Okay, at the coffee shop here we are going to turn right. Go to the end of
Park Street.
Park Street. After that, turn right into King's Road. So we are standing here. We are going to turn right. The bookshop is on the
left.
Very good. Yeah. هلا لاحظوا معلومة أحيانا كثير whenever we are giving directions تخيلوا إنه أنتوا هلا في وجه الشاشة هلا طبعا يكون ظهركم للي عم يوصف فإحنا ماشيين نفس الخريطة وكأنه الخريطة موجودة والشارع أمامنا. فلما بنحكي turn right على يمينكم on the left على يساركم وكأنه إحنا ماشيين يعني اعتبروها إنه 3D dimensions. After the
shoe shop.
طبعا شو هو نوع من أنواع الفن إنه مسمينها مش shoes محل أحذية shoe shop اللي هو محل الحذاء. Thanks very much. Number 2. Excuse me. How do I get to the department store? So he wants to go to the department store. Where is the department store? Here it is. This is number 2. Okay, yeah, let's complete the directions. Go down this road. معناته here. نرجع stop here. Go down this road to the
crossroad.
To the
crossroad.
No. ما في crossroad يا جماعة. The crossroad بيكون في عندي أربع طرق. This is a crossroad. لكن إحنا لسه ما وصلنا هون. إحنا go down this road to the
end.
End. إلى النهاية حتى آخر الشارع. هلا آخر الشارع في عندنا خيارين. Turn right. إحنا هون. هاي turn right. Okay. Go
down.
Down. Yeah. Go down. لاحظ مفهوم down مش معناها تحت في هذه الحالة. معناها إنه لآخر الشارع. This is the end of down. Go down Elmway. ماشي. هينا. لفينا إلى اليسار آخر الشارع. هاي Elmway. بعدين.
Past.
Very good. Yeah. Past the bank. عدوا البنك. And King's Road. كمان بدنا نعدي الشارع. This is King's Road. معناته رح نعدي هذا الشارع. Okay. معناته تقريبا وصلنا هون. The department store is on the
left.
Left. Very good. رح يكون على يسارنا. Number 3. Excuse me, where is the bus station? So now we are asking about the bus station. So this is the station and this is number three. This is the third place they are asking about. Okay, نرجع مرة تانية. We are standing here. It's on Station Hill Road. Giving location. حدد موقعها. هي موجودة على هذا الشارع. بلش يعطي الاتجاهات. Go down this road. بعدين turn
left.
Left طبعا. Turn left. لازم نتجه إلى اليسار. لأنه على حسب الشارع. Turn left at the cinema. This is the cinema. Turn left. لفينا يسار. يا
هو بده الباص الباص ستيشن مش الستيش
لحظة where is the bus station yeah this is the station هي نفس المحطة هلا this is the bus stop هاي هذا بسميها محطة التوقف اللي موجودة هون bus stop اللي هو بكون زي الكشك إله مظلة واقفين عنده لكن هو going to the station this is the station هيها لاحظوا
ستيشن نفسها هي تاعت الباص ستيشن
هي نفسها تاعت القطار شكلها تاعت الباص يا احنا من الشكل حكينا انه this is going to be a train station بس لا هي شكلها الستيشن نفسها بغض النظر بس ستيشن remember unit number 5 when we talked about means of transportation حكينا انه القطارات والباصات بنستخدم معها the word station فهمت شو قصدك اوكي I'm sorry just a minute okay فهمت لحظة We are asking about this. This is the bus station. Just a minute. Yeah. And I'm looking at the word station. So this is the bus station. هيك قصدك صح? No, this is the bus station. Yeah, that's correct. يلا. صح هيك? Yeah, this is the idea. Yeah, thank you. Okay. شكرا للتنبيه. Now, it's on Hill Station Road. Go down this road. Turn left at the cinema. Go to the
end.
Yeah, إلى آخر الشارع. Go to the end of the road. And it's on your
left.
Left. Come on. Also, it's on our left. Thank you. So this is the idea. هلا notice مرة تانية برجع بنبهكم إنه at the exam طبعاً you will not have a map ومطلوب منكم إن to go on these directions. لا, most of the times تكون the idea اللي هي to give locations, to ask for locations, أو to give directions. فبتكون الفكرة واضحة جداً. تكون only one sentence with one function. لكن notice here that we have all of the three functions together in the conversation. فit's a matter of practice. Nothing more, nothing less. Okay. طبعاً here we have a practice also. طبعاً إحنا لو كان التعليم وجاهي يكون في عندي a matter of practice between students and they are going to ask and give directions and locations. Now, the review, okay, هيك بنكون إحنا we have finished the second part of the unit. هلا بنيجي to the review. We have taken this last time. Now here vocabulary, let's see. Yeah, match the words with the pictures. Locations, first one, Let me see. Between is?
Between C.
C.
Thank you. C. Opposite?
A.
A. Very good. Yeah, this is the idea. أحيانا كثير الطلاب بيعتبروا إنه opposite مقابل إنه أي شيء يعني ممكن يكونوا جنب بعض. لا, انتبهوا. Opposite دائما لازم يكون عندي. Between them a street. لازم يكون على الجهة المقابلة من الشارع بده يكون face to face يعني واجهة أمامية مقابل واجهة أمامية This is the idea of opposite Opposite معناها مش عكس معناها مقابل Number three At the end of Next to
B
B ولاحظ أنه next to B اللي هي ملاصق له near بكون قريب منه on the corner
دي
ايه هلا ايه حلناها on the corner this is the corner حكينا we must have two roads او two streets whenever we talk a corner هي على زاوية الشارع ليش صار عندي زاوية معروف ان الزاويه عباره عن التقاء خطين مستقيمين في نقطه ما، فهي الزاويه هاي راح تكون عندنا هلا بغض النظر زاويه حاده منفرجه قائمه we don't have a problem اسمها كورنر اللي هي زاويه. طبعا كورنر زي كلمه انجل، فديروا بالكم لهي المعلومه we must have two roads here. Okay, now here we have two pictures. Find five differences, then write the differences between the two pictures. Let's see. The first one is done for us. In picture A, there is a man next to the car. In picture B, there is a woman next to the car. Can you find other differences between the two pictures? What do you think?
عدد السيارات.
Number of the cars. لا هلا always make short sentences. The simplest, the better. Okay? هلا طلعوا هون. In picture A, there isn't a taxi at the taxi stop. In picture B, there is a taxi. هيك خلوا الجمل بسيطة جدا. So this is sentence number one. In picture B, there is a bank next to the fresh fire. But in picture A, there is a new cafe, or the new cafe is next to the fresh fire. In picture B, there is a bank next to the fresh fire. لاحظوا, these are the differences. طلعوا البنك هون اختلف مكانه تماما. فهاي أحد الأمور اللي بدنا نطلع عليها. In picture A, there is a man sitting on the chair between the man and the woman. Right? In picture B, طبعا I'm not sure the الصورة واضحة أو لا. Here we have different people. لاحظوا. Here you have the same people here on the right, on the left. But here you have a man. Here I'm not sure if this is a woman. But you have a different person. لاحظوا, in picture B you have a different person sitting between the man and the woman. What else? Can you find other differences? In picture A, there is a white car in front of the chemist. In picture B, there isn't a white car. There isn't even a chemist. What else? طبعا ممكن يكون في سيارة بيضة بس مقطوشة مع الصورة but I don't think so. ممكن. What else? Do you have other differences? بينت معكم اختلافات ولا مش مبين معكم؟ يعني this is an example. Here, okay, هذا بنسميه in picture A we have a meter, a car meter. أو park meter اللي هو العداد usually when cars stop for a period of time they pay. In picture B you don't have a park meter. لا يوجد عداد. ف okay يعني some of the differences between them. هلا the idea is to practice just to talk about the differences we have here in the picture. Okay طيب هلا work skills looking after a visitor. Now we have the conversation. You are going to put them in the right order. We have A and B. B sometimes is missing. Yeah, let's complete the conversation. We are going to use the phrases here. Can I help you with anything else? How was your flight this morning? Please come this way. Would you like a drink? How is the hotel? Pleased to meet you. Starting with A. Good afternoon. I'm Evangelina Ricardo. I have a meeting with Mr. Henry. Good afternoon, Ms. Ricardo. I'm Kevin. I'm Mr. Henry's assistant.
Pleased to meet you.
Thank you. Pleased to meet you. So this is going to be number one. Here, this is number one. Pleased to meet you. Good. Pleased to meet you too. معناته the answer is correct. الإجابة كانت صحيحة معنا 100%. طيب ما في داعي نكتبهم، خلاص I'm going to write just the number. هلا it was fine. Thank you. What
was your flight?
Thank you. How was your flight? أو نسأل أول سؤال عن الرحلة قبل السؤال عن الفندق. How was your flight? كيف كانت رحلتك هذا الصباح؟ It was fine. Thank you. I have a very nice room. Thank you. It's very quiet.
How is the hotel?
Excellent. Yeah. How is the hotel? So the third question is about the hotel. Good. Now, هي سألته سؤال أو هو سألها سؤال. Yes, I'll have a mineral water, please. What was the question?
Would you like a drink?
Would you like a drink? فبالتالي كانت عندي الإجابة. Yes, I'd like mineral water. No problem. Here you are. Thank you very much. My pleasure.
Can I help you?
Yeah. مش can I, can I. Okay, Bridget, امسكوها مع بعض. Can I help you with something else? Okay. And the answer was, I don't think so. Okay.
Please come this way.
Please come this way. لو سمحت تفضل من هنا. We are going to the meeting room. So this is the idea here. Okay. طبعا لاحظوا عندكم most of the times conversations بيكون عندكم depending on the answer you can find the question and vice versa وبالعكس. فthey are connected together. بيكون في عنا شيء بنسميه agreement between the question and the answer. Okay. يلا. Now, answer the questions about Evangelina Ricardo. Who is she meeting?
Mr. Henry.
Thank you. She is going to meet Mr. Henry. Who does she meet first, Mr. Henry or Kevin? من قابلت في البداية, Mr. Henry, the one she is going to meet, or Kevin?
Kevin.
Kevin, yeah, he is the assistant. دائما notice. طبعا استخدمنا two words to describe. هلا when he talked about himself, he said, I am Mr. Henry's assistant. أنا مساعد السيد هنري. لاحظوا المعلومة. لكن ممكن نستخدم كلمة ثانية. Can you remember the other word we have taken before? يلا علمتين للي بيتذكرها.
Helper.
Helper. لا ما استخدمنا كلمة helper. المصطلح ضلنا نستخدمه اللي هو PA. لاحظوا هلا PA اللي هي اختصار كلمات personal assistant. نفس الكلمة اللي موجودة عندكم here. طبعا هو فورا حكى I am Mr. Henry's assistant. فدائما بما انه هو المساعد الشخصي له فدائما عندكم هون كلمة personal assistant. بنسميهم PA. يعني احيانا ما في داعي حتى انه يحكي personal assistant او the word assistant. بيحكي I am the PA. مرت معنا الكلمة أكثر من مرة. ف this is the idea here. طيب. Did she have a good flight?
Yes.
Yes. Yes, she did. حكت it was quite good. كانت جيدة لا بأس بها. Is her hotel noisy?
No.
No. It's very quiet.
Very quiet.
بس هادئ حكت it's very quiet. هادئ جدا. it is. I'm sorry, here. What does she want to drink?
Water.
Mineral water.
Yeah, mineral water. مياه معدنية أو نسميها مياه صحة. Okay, mineral water. Now, the last part, asking, okay, for and giving directions. Asking for directions. We use these questions to ask the way to a place. Now, this is the function, طالكم متذكرين. Asking for and giving directions. Asking for, giving, في عندي two functions. في عندي كمان giving location. Now, the first one, اللي هي asking for directions, we use questions. Always, when asking for directions, we use questions. Where is the bank? Is there a coffee shop near here? How do I get to the hospital? You usually say, excuse me first and thank you at the end. هذا من أنواع التهذيب because the person was so polite to give, to answer our question. Now, the second function اللي هي giving directions to say where a place is, we use prepositions of location. لاحظوا لازم دائما يكون في عندي استخدام to what we call prepositions of locations. طبعا حروف الجر لكن في هاي الحالة حروف الجر دلالتها بتكون على حسب إنه after it you have a place معناته بكل بساطة صارت preposition of location هي تقريبا زي بتصير هنا بظرف مكان it's on Bolivar Road it's next to the bus station it's opposite the supermarket it's on the left it's between And remember, between, لازم يكون I have two places, the station and the cinema. The third function, اللي هي to give directions, we use the verb. دائما لازم يكون عندي فعل. ونأكد على معلومة أخرى, اللي هي the verb doesn't change. لسبب بسيط جدا, إنه the verb is going to be in the imperative. Do you know the meaning of imperative?
مثبت؟
لا هلا هو 100% مثبت بس له طلع go straight on turn left لاحظوا الكلمات اللي موجودة عندكم معناته في هاي الحالة عم نعطي ايش؟ سميها instructions عم نعطي تعليمات whenever you are giving instructions ايش نوع الفعل اللي بنستخدمه في إعطاء التعليمات؟
فعل منتظم
فعل أمر سميه فعل أمر لما نقول له go straight on اذهب مباشرة turn left اتجه إلى اليسار turn right اتجه إلى اليمين أنا عم بعطيه أمر طبعا نسميها instructions أنا عم بعطيه تعليمات أو directions في هاي الحالة دائما الفعل بيكون بصيغة الأمر that's why it does not change هلا in Arabic language we have three tenses عندنا الأزمان في اللغة العربية we have three tenses اللي هي طبعا مضارع وماضي وأمر in English language how many tenses do we have يلا علامتين للي بيجاوبني how many tenses do we have in English language يلا صيدل you are wasting your marks شو رأيكم كم من زمان
ثلاث
اللي هم
ماضي ومضارع
ومستقبل
ومستمر أيام
تأكدين المعلومة طيب رح يكون لنا محاضرة Okay.
Yes.
عشان تكونوا بالصورة we only have two tenses in English language present and past فقط زمنين مضارع وماضي هلا لما نحكي present موجود عندي simple present present continuous present perfect وpresent perfect continuous. لما بنحكي past معناته في عندي past simple مضارع البسيط, past continuous, past perfect, past perfect continuous. لاحظوا انه في كل وصف للفعل استخدمت اسم الزمن اما present واما past. فهاي المعلومة حطوها في بالكم. We only have two tenses in English language. هلا بتحكوا future. فعليا we don't have a real future in English language. ما في عندي زمن حقيقي اسمه future. احنا بنستخدم دلالات الزمن المضارع to talk about the future. يعني بتحكوا I am going to. استخدمنا the present continuous. I am studying. استخدمنا the present continuous. The train leaves tomorrow at. استخدمنا simple present. I will meet you tomorrow. استخدمنا المودل, لكن المودل will زمن مضارع. فلاحظوا فعليا we don't have a real future in English language. احنا عم نستخدم أشكال مختلفة من المضارع, الفعل المضارع بأشكاله حتى إنه احنا نعبر عن الزمن المستقبل. لكن فعليا ما في عندي. هلا لو جيت سألتكم turn left, go straight, turn right, ايش زمنها؟ بما انه ما في عندي فعل امر باللغة الانجليزية, right؟ ايش زمنه؟
مضارع.
مضارع, thank you very much. مضارع. مين اللي عم تحكي, خلود ولا مين؟
لا, براءة.
براءة, very good يا براءة. اوكي, زمن مضارع. فعلياً هون في عندكم ضمير محذوف وجوباً لأنه مفهوم ضمناً من السياق اللي هو مين؟ You, أنت. حتى بالعربي إذا بدكم تعربوا بتقولوا اذهب من هنا. اذهب فعل أمر مبني, right؟ والفعل ضمير مستتر تقديره أنت. فإن English language نفس الشيء, في عندي ضمير مستتر اللي هو أنت لأنه أنا عم بحكي مباشرة مع شخص موجود أمامي. ففعل الأمر فعلياً هو فعل مضارع in English language. English is very simple. ما فيها التعقيدات الكثيرة الموجودة في اللغات الأخرى. But this is the idea here. Okay? واضحة الفكرة؟ Okay. Let's do the exercises depending on this. يلا. Match the questions from 1 to 3 with the answers. Let's see. Where is the hospital?
Scene.
Okay. بما أنه this is a question, it's opposite the park, right? Is there a cinema near here?
No, there isn't.
No, there isn't. Yeah. How do I get to the chemist?
They're left at the hotel.
Yeah, it's next to the coffee shop. Okay, the last exercise we have here. We have a map. Look at the map. You are in the new hotel on Elgar Road. يعني أنت موجود داخل الفندق على شارع Elgar. Now, what are you going to do? You are going to complete the conversation. Now, where are you standing?
Excuse.
Here. يلا. We are standing here. You are in the new hotel. أنت داخل الفندق. And the new hotel is on Angle Road. يلا. حلو. Okay. بلشنا. We say at the beginning من باب التهذيب إيش؟
Excuse.
Thank you. Excuse me. تكسروهاش كتير. لا. Excuse me. حاولوا تخلوها خفيفة قد ما بتقدروا. Excuse me. Okay. بمعنى عذرا أو لو سمحت من فضلك. سؤال. أداة اللي بنستخدمها للسؤال عن المكان WH where.
Where is.
Thank you. Where's the station? It's on. This is the station. معناته it's on.
اسم Queens شارع. Road.
Queens Road.
It's on Queens Road. على شارع Queens. طبعا لاحظوا الأبوستروفي اللي موجودة. It's on. Queens Road على شارع الملكة. Do I get there?
How?
How?
Thank you. How do I get there? كيف أذهب إلى هناك؟ Go out of the hotel. يلا بلش يعطي directions. Go out of the hotel. And
turn.
Turn ايش؟
Turn.
Yeah. Turn right. Yeah. Turn right. اتجه إلى اليمين. ماشي. Go straight on. ضلك ماشي دغري. Then
supermarket.
لسا في عندي اتجاهين بده يعطيني اياهم.
Turn right.
Excellent. Yeah. Then turn right. كمان مرة you are going to turn right into Queens Road. بدنا ندخل في الشارع نفسه. معناته رح ننعطف إلى اليمين. Turn right. أوكي هينا انعطفنا هون. The station is on the
left.
Yeah. رح تكون موجودة على يسارنا. بده يعطيني كمان معلومة حتى يساعدني وعلاقتها مع البارك.
Opposite.
Opposite. Excellent. Yeah. Opposite the park. مقابل المنتزه أو الحديقة العامة. Thank you very much. No problem. Okay. So here we come to the end of unit number 9. Okay. طبعاً اللي هي هلا the functions asking for giving directions and locations. I hope you know, everything is going to be clear for you.